Hi students, let's see here next points of the water resources of Karnataka, that is hydroelectric power. In the last class we learned about the irrigation facility in our Karnataka. Yes, as I told you in the last class about irrigation facilities are very necessary for our agriculture purpose, and Karnataka has a 9th position in India for the irrigation facility. Okay, and today we are going to learn about in this class hydroelectric power. So the credit for successful generation of a hydroelectric power for the first time in India goes to Karnataka. Yes, students. So this is very proud to us. Okay, India dalli modalige hydroelectric power na tayar madidavaru yaru antandre Karnataka davaru. Idu ondu namge hemmeya vishaya. Okay, so the credit for the successful generation of a hydroelectric power for the first time in India goes to Karnataka. Yes, and coal or petroleum is not available in our state. Yes, we know that in our state we can't get the coal and the petroleum, but by using the great opportunity for the generation of hydropower, so there are rivers which can provide sufficient power for the whole state. Yes, students, in the water irrigation and the rivers we seen that. Okay, we learn about the types of rivers which are flowing in Karnataka: east flowing rivers and the west flowing rivers. And as I told you, by west flowing rivers we can get the hydroelectric power, because the west flowing rivers are born in the Western Ghat. Okay, so in the Western Ghat, so by the Western Ghat they flow down. Okay, when the water flow, when the river flow down, flow from the upper side of the hill to the down to the land, then it falls water, it creates waterfalls, and so many waterfalls we can see in the Karnataka, and that too very special famous Jog Falls. The famous one is Jog Falls, which is famous in the worldwide, and it is the biggest Jog Fall in India. Okay, and that's why here when we are not getting the coal and the petroleum to produce the hydroelectric power, then also the Karnataka peoples talk about the generate the hydroelectric power by using the water falls. Okay, by using the water falls they generated the hydel power in Karnataka. So there are rivers which can provide sufficient power for the whole state, and rivers flowing towards the west are most suitable for power generation than the rivers flowing towards the east. As I told you, now I just told you nimge western side flow aguvanta rivers namge hydroelectric power anna generate madakke thumba useful agive. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅವು ಹಿಲ್ಸ್ ಇಂದ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಬೀಳೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ವಾಟರ್ ಫಾಲ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅದು ವೇಗವಾಗಿ ಮೇಲಿಂದ ನೀರು ಬೀಳೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ವೀಲ್ ಇಟ್ಟು ಅದನ್ನ ವೀಲಿಂದ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಪವರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಜನರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಈಸ್ಟ್ ಫ್ಲೋವಿಂಗ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಇಂದ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಪ್ರಮಾಣದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಪವರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ಕೆ ಅಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಸೂಟೇಬಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಆದ್ರೂ ಕೂಡ ಕೃಷ್ಣಾ ನದಿಯಿಂದ ನಾವೇನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಹೈಡ್ರೋಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಪವರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕೂಡ ಪಡಿತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಅದು ಎಲ್ಲಿ, ಉತ್ತರ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಸೈಡ್ ನಾವು ಕೃಷ್ಣಾ ರಿವರ್ ಇಂದ ನಾವು ಹೈಡ್ರೋಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಪವರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಪಡಿತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಸಿ ದ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಪವರ್ ಸ್ಟೇಷನ್ ಅಟ್ ಶಿವನ ಸಮುದ್ರ ವಾಸ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಶ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ 1902. ಓಕೆ, in hydroelectric power station at the Shivan Samudra was established in which year? 1902, to supply power. to the polar gold mine. First ಇಲ್ಲಿ polar mine gold mine ಗೆ power supply ಮಾಡಕ್ಕೆ 1902 ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಶಿವನ ಸಮುದ್ರ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಶಿವನ ಸಮುದ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಜೋಗ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಲ್ಲ ನಿಮಗೆ ಶಿವನ ಸಮುದ್ರ ನದಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಜೋಗ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೈಡಲ್ ಪವರ್ ಅನ್ನು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಯಾವ ಇಯರ್ಲಿ 1902 ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆನ್ ರಿವರ್ ಕಾವೇರಿ ಎಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆನ್ ರಿವರ್ ಕಾವೇರಿ ಕಾವೇರಿ ರಿವರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ರಿವರ್ ಗೆ ಈ ರಿವರ್ ಹತ್ರ ಈ ಒಂದು ಶಿವನ ಸಮುದ್ರ ಹ್ಯಾಡಲ್ ಪವರ್ ಅನ್ನು ನಿರ್ಮಿಸಲಾಗಿದೆ ಸೊ ಆಟ್ ಅ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ distance at a short distance away from the second hydro power station was established on Shimsha river in 1940 yes near Shivan Samudra hydro power there is another one hydroelectric power that is Shimsha hydroelectric power built near on the river of Shimsha in the year 1940 And the Mahatma Gandhi hydroelectric power station was established in 1947 near Jog Falls. Jog Falls alli yen madidru hydroelectric power create aagidru generate madidru avaga 1947 on Sharavati river as we know Jog Falls is created on the river Sharavati okay and it fulfilled the increased demand to demand for hydroelectric power it idu en martide hydro falls dalli hydroelectric power create aadmele idu karnataka thumba en martide eshtu sufficient aagi electric power anna supply maadlike helpful aitu jog falls and later many more hydro projects were developed under the 5-year plans and as a result of this development karnataka ranks first in the generation of a hydroelectric power in india yes students here there is a no point to think more or the be a confusion for the this chapter this point okay hydroelectric power which is generated by the water or the waterfalls okay and the credit goes to Karnataka to supply to get a successful generation for the successful generation of a hydroelectric power in the India. In the India for the first time, and because in Karnataka we don't have coals and petroleum, so that's why by using the waterfalls in Karnataka we produce. Hydroelectric power and the first hydroelectric power station was established in 1902 in Shivanasamudra at Shivanasamudra which to supply the power for the polar gold mining and it, this Shivanasamudra project built across the constructed across the Kaveri river and after that second hydro power station was built on Shimsha river in 1940 and after that in 1947 Mahatma Gandhi hydroelectric power station was established on near Jog Falls on Sharavati river to fulfill the increased demand for the hydroelectric power afterwards so many electric hydroelectric powers generated under the 5-year plans and Karnataka is the first place Karnataka has the first place in India for the hydroelectric generation if you have any doubts about this clear your doubts read more be good thank you